This is a simple observation anyone can do at home. You need a container, put water in it, cover the entry of the container, and invert it. You've just made anti-gravity water. Or did gravity just have a sick day today? Maybe if we put the mass of the water closer to the mass of the Earth, this will increase the gravity. No? How about we accelerate the mass to increase the force of gravity? Still not working. I know, this is no longer the accepted theory of gravity for today. What we need to do is bend some space-time. Just bending a bit of space-time, trying to make gravity appear? Gravity just doesn't want to turn up. Tell you what, if gravity were a person, it would be constantly unemployed, because it never turns up to work. What I'm demonstrating here is this very weak vacuum is stronger than gravity. So if we see this very weak vacuum overcome gravity at its strongest when it is closer to the Earth, why then do we never see the extreme infinite vacuum of space overcome gravity at its weakest at a further distance? But yet we are told by the heliocentric magicians the entire atmosphere is pulled down by gravity. Don't take any notice of the natural law this violates, and the globe literally being the only example of this violation and can't be demonstrated. Well, I've got a magic trick too. I can use my wand to make gravity appear. Did the water just fall due to gravity? Again, this isn't gravity. If it were helium inside the container, it would not fall. It would rise out of the container. What we're seeing here is the second law of thermodynamics, and also nature abhorring a vacuum, meaning nature can never allow a vacuum to exist. When the container is inverted, the pressure inside is slightly less than the pressure outside the container. The air pressure outside is pushing on the container from all directions. The higher pressure wants to flow to the lower pressure, but the lid prevents the higher pressure entering. So the vacuum inside the container is not sucking the water and holding it up. The slightly higher pressure on the outside is pushing against the lid, trying to get in. But when the surface tension is disturbed, the contents of the container do not fall due to gravity. It is pushed out from the pressure rushing in to create equilibrium of air pressure. This is entropy, following the second law of thermodynamics. The higher pressure enters the container, pushing the water out, and the water falls due to relative density, whilst finding equilibrium of pressure. High pressure always flowing from higher to lower and never flowing in reverse. This is a natural law without exception. So how is it that the high air pressure of our atmosphere does not immediately try to find equilibrium with the very low infinite vacuum of space directly next to it? Well, it's obviously not due to gravity, as demonstrated by this very weak vacuum. This also demonstrates nature abhorring a vacuum. There are literally no examples of a naturally occurring vacuum. Nature always seeks equilibrium, so a natural vacuum is impossible. This here is a man-made vacuum. And a very weak one, defying gravity. And that up there is also a man-made vacuum. So what I'd like to put to you, after I demonstrate how hard it is to break this very weak vacuum, which is taking a lot of force here, is if man never existed, then a vacuum would never have existed, because nature always seeks equilibrium, so there is no such thing as a natural vacuum. So if you still think we're living on a spinning globe, flying through space, you've successfully been indoctrinated.